Those documents tell one part of the story, but another part has been coming out over the last 2 weeks in a federal courtroom in Brooklyn, New York. John Miller now on the story of the men who worked for bin Laden.
Many have heard of Richard Reed, the so-called shoe bomber, who was caught trying to blow up a Miami-bound plane in late 2001. Fewer people have heard of Sajid Badat, the other shoe bomber. He changed his mind and never boarded his flight, but in a video deposition, he told prosecutors of Al-Qaeda's plan.
It was to take this shoe on board an American airline and then detonate it.
Did you understand that could mean killing potentially hundreds of innocent people?
Yes.
And Badat told of meeting Osama bin Laden.
I was called to meet with Osama bin Laden in person. It was just the two of us in the room.
The mission was about more than crashing a plane. It was to crash the airline industry.
So he said that the American economy is like a chain. If you break one link of the chain, the whole economy will be brought down.
Badat's deposition was played at a trial about three New York men charged with plotting to bomb the New York City subways in 2009. Another Al-Qaeda recruit from New York, Bryant Venus, testified he plotted to bomb a Walmart store and the Long Island Railroad to cause the big economic hit Al-Qaeda leaders wanted. Don Borelli, a former FBI agent, was involved in the investigation.
They understand the psyche of the West, that even a small plot that's successful will cause huge economic disruption.
Al-Qaeda is weaker than it was a few years ago, but is still trying to recruit Westerners.
This is the crown jewel for Al-Qaeda, to be able to have somebody like that, that they can trust, that they can train, and then reinsert back into their homeland and carry out an attack essentially whenever they deem appropriate.
Now, that point was underscored in this trial. The three New York men charged in the subway plot had joined Al-Qaeda to fight American soldiers in Afghanistan. But when Al-Qaeda leaders learned that they were Americans with U.S. passports, they asked them to go home and carry out that attack on the New York City subway system. So the jury begins deliberations in that case today.
Thank you very much, John.